Really good. I've been taking my time in here working hard every day with the strength guys, the sports science guys, all the trainers, pretty hard every day. So pretty happy to be back at this point and just excited, looking forward to that first game back.
You expect to play Saturday?
Hopefully. Still a little bit up in the air, but I think it's pretty hopeful. So working towards that for sure.
It's important to get a sense of rhythm prior to the postseason, because it's obviously going to see the hockey ramped up a bit.
During that time, given the team will be playing?
Yeah, like I said, you just try to get in for at least a couple of games back before playoffs, just to try to get that rhythm back. So that was kind of our goal since the day I got hurt. Just try to look to see if I can get back for a few before playoffs and get back in the rhythm of things and get going.
Do you feel like before you were hurt, or do you have to get in a game to really know if you're back to the same level?
I mean, practices seem almost easier, where I think I'm maybe in better condition, but I guess, like you said, you won't see it until you're in a game.
Austin has talked about it took him a while to get feeling like his old self when he had his shoulder injury. Just how, what's the biggest challenge, you think, being ready for game one of the playoffs?
I think these guys in here have been working me so hard so that I don't have to second guess myself when I come back. So I think that's the biggest thing for me, whether that takes a game or two, just to try to get that out of my mind and make sure every shift I'm out there not thinking about second guessing myself. Just going out there and playing my game, and like you guys said, just getting back to the point where I was before, and not second guessing myself, playing the game that I can play.
Watching from the side, you obviously have a different perspective. What did you see from the team and while you were sidelined?
I mean, every team goes through its ups and downs. It's definitely been tough not being able to help out and do my part as much as I want to. But I mean, we're learning from our mistakes, and hopefully when I come back, we can get into a little bit of rhythm here before playoffs.
You're looking forward not to spending regular time with strength coaches, and maybe it goes both ways.
Yeah, the wind bike is going to be out of my sight for a few weeks, hopefully.
We saw Jake, you know, at practice for the first time since he was rolled out late in February. You maybe spent more time with him than other guys during his process. How has he maintained his, you know, demeanor since he's been forced to miss time?
Yeah, Jake's always a guy that's positive in here. Great guy to have around, real good guy for me to look up to. And kind of weird how we were both kind of going through the same type of thing at the same time, where we were in here every day together. So we got some good chemistry going between us, which is a little fun. But I mean, since the first time we were on the ice together, he's definitely looking a lot better. And he's been working his bag off. So he's definitely figured it out, and looking forward to hopefully seeing him back soon.
What would it be like if you're playing with Marty on Saturday? How do you see that chemistry?
I love Marv. I've called him Dad since the Marlies days, but he's a good guy to have around. Good, great guy to talk to. He's kind of shy when you first meet him, but he's one of the funnier guys once you get him to open up to you. And really easy guy to play with too. He's really defensively sound, and I feel like we got some good chemistry. So looking forward to it if I'm with him.